Bonjour tout le monde. Je suis très heureux d'être ici accompagné de la ministre Joly et du haut-commissaire Godéon. Aujourd'hui, on a terminé la réunion des chefs de gouvernement du Commonwealth ici au Rwanda. C'était une occasion de discuter avec nos partenaires de plusieurs enjeux comme la guerre injustifiable de la Russie en Ukraine, la sécurité alimentaire et les changements climatiques. We also talked about the importance of supporting efforts to modernize and reform the Commonwealth and of strengthening democracy, good governance, and respect for human rights in countries around the world. We're in a critical time right now. We're all feeling the impacts of Russia's illegal invasion of Ukraine through rising food and fuel prices and supply chain issues. We must continue to stand up to Putin. We must work together with partners and allies to support Ukraine's independence, sovereignty, and territorial integrity, as well as Ukraine's democracy. This is about global stability, security, and prosperity, and it's something that I raised in my one-on-one conversations with many leaders, including with the presidents of Rwanda, Ghana, Botswana, Kenya, and Zambia, as well as with the prime ministers of Antigua, Jamaica, Singapore, among many others. À plusieurs endroits dans le monde, on est en train de vivre de l'insécurité alimentaire. Avec les routes d'exportation bloquées en Ukraine ou la hausse du prix des engrais causée par la guerre, Vladimir Poutine empire la crise alimentaire. Le Canada va continuer d'être là pour aider les pays les plus touchés. C'est pour ça que jeudi, on a annoncé un investissement de 250 millions de dollars supplémentaires pour soutenir les principales organisations humanitaires en alimentation et en nutrition. Investing in food security around the world matters to vulnerable people who are hungry, and it matters to Canadians because it fosters stability that benefits everyone. We're continuing our work to improve people's lives. This morning, we participated in an event with the Commonwealth youth leaders. We discussed the importance of education and skills training to give more opportunities to more people, especially young people, and announced this week $94 million in funding for education, including through international scholarships and funding to improve primary school learning outcomes in Liberia and Sierra Leone. We're also going to invest $120 million in initiatives that will support gender equality in Commonwealth countries. This includes, for example, funding to support sexual and reproductive health and rights in Nigeria. It also includes research projects to improve health systems and pandemic preparedness. With women's rights under attack in many parts of the world, we must and we will continue investing in more access to safe sexual and reproductive health services for women everywhere. In many meetings, we had the opportunity to discuss efforts to tackle climate change and keep people safe. This week, we're announcing that we'll invest over $30 million in different initiatives to share information and promote nature-based solutions to fight climate change. This investment will also help with different projects that support peace and security throughout the African continent. To improve people's lives, we have to work together, and that's why it's so important to strengthen our relationships with Africa. Comme on l'a annoncé cette semaine, on va convertir le bureau du Canada au Rwanda en un plein haut-commissariat, ce qui va augmenter notre capacité pour les services diplomatiques, et on va établir une mission spécifique et un ambassadeur auprès de l'Union africaine basé en Éthiopie. On a aussi signé un accord sur le transport aérien Canada-Rwanda pour que nos pays soient mieux connectés. C'est une initiative qui va être profitable pour les gens qui veulent voyager et pour les entreprises en croissance. The world is facing many challenges. Russia's war in Ukraine, food insecurity, climate change, continued pandemic. I look forward to continuing to work to address these challenges during the G7 in Germany starting tomorrow. And I want to again thank Rwanda for hosting a successful summit here in Kigali. President Kagame did an outstanding job. But before I finish, I want to pause for a moment on the terrible news coming out of Oslo today. We send our deepest condolences to the victims and the families and loved ones of the families. LGBTQ2 people and everyone should never live in fear or be subjected to violence because of who they are or whom they love. Aujourd'hui, on est solidaire avec les communautés LGBTQ2 en Norvège et à travers le monde. Merci beaucoup.